The main thing is my concerns is this damn pandemic and then the bubble shit. You know, because I've been hearing some different shit with this bubble shit, how the coaches can't, you know, do what they do with the fighter when it's time to do it with it. So the main thing you want to do is be close to shit so you'd be ready to deal with the shit.
Yeah. We gotta take a test. We gotta start testing this week too.
This week? Yeah.
Well, I've been testing for the last 2 months, man.
Yeah, I know. Matter of fact, I think Monday I gotta find me a spot down here to see where I'm at, because you know, when I got down here I was all clean. So I'm gonna check it Monday and see what I got the results I got here since I've been in Vegas. What I'm gonna do. I'm gonna find a spot down here where I can get tested at.
How everybody going down there?
Well, everybody good. We lived in right now. We lived in, you know, we eating good. We training good.
I'm learning the flow. How they
doing? Floyd doing good, man. Floyd come and hang out with us every spawn day, man. That nigga crazy. Y'all be having a ball with Floyd, yo. He be in there like, he coming in, he sit back, he ain't bothering nobody. You know, but we be teasing each other. When he come around to watch Tank, I leave. He like, what the fuck happened at? And then when he leave, I go,
We got to hang out with Floyd outside of boxing. Go take him to the pool table.
Yeah, he talking about he want to show his other mansions and shit out. You know what I'm saying?
He said, man, I ain't think about no mansion. He can, man, put me in the TP. I'm good.
I try to tell him that. We don't pay attention to that shit.
I ain't worried about no damn mansion. Go see some pool.
You know how Floyd is, man. Floyd,
he can hang out with us and eat some oodles and noodles, man. We ain't worried about no magic.
We don't worry about that shit.
Floyd crazy.
Yeah, Floyd crazy, yo. But when he in the gym, when they spawn, yo, that nigga be in there tripping, yo.
Yeah.
That nigga be in there tripping, yo. He be having some fun.
I be looking at his doghouse on YouTube. They got to come down, doghouse.
Yeah, that's what I was trying to say. Like, yo, okay, they having a ball. I'm going to try to bring that shit to him and show him what we got. Huh?
Bring the pit. Tell him what the pit bulls look like.
Yeah, I ain't really bring them all out. He seen Tank and all of them. He ain't really get to see all of them. What you call it? You know, Truck went back home and shit. I was hoping I could get some work for Truck here.
No, Truck called us last night. He was trying to come up here and train, but we in the bubble, right?
Yeah.
Everybody got to stay up here. Yeah, I wish he could have came, but we can't have nobody that's outside because of this pandemic.
Yeah, I wanted Chuck to come up here on a spawn day and whoop some asses for me so I can watch Baby Boy, the little baby, whoop some asses.
Right.
Yeah.
It's all good. It'll come together in the future, though.
No, I already know. I try to explain to them. Each one of them got their courses. Each one of them got their battles. You know what I'm saying? And they got to deal with it. But they got to work together. And, you know, that comes between them of doing it. But, you know, they brothers. That's what brothers do. But when it's time.
Come out the same house.
The same cloth, man. That's why I don't sit here and trip off, you know?
Army up.
Yeah, it's a whole, like you said, Fun post that picture of them three, and then he posts this three. I start laughing and shit. I said, okay, they get the picture. They get the picture.
We got some more. I wish Lil Shorty was on that picture, man.
Which one?
On the little picture.
Shake and Bake?
Yeah, Shake and Bake.
Yeah, but Fun didn't put him up there, you know. That was Fun and his thought. That was his line, you know. We got a whole bunch of combinations. We got Grinch, you know, Grinch.
Malik Wong could have been with the big boy, but they didn't post the shit.
Yeah, yeah.
It's so many of them, you know.
Right, that's why I said to say, what course did they stay in? That's why I'm getting to it, you know. Each one of them got their generations and when they come, you know. Yeah, that's just like, when this is how I look at it. You got Tank, Malik, and Truck. See, when they get into that pinnacle, they coming up behind them. So then you got to look for the next one that's going to take their place. You get it?
The next generation.
What ones that's going to take them? Now, see, in Malik position, he by himself. You know what I'm saying? The rest of them got to catch up behind Malik. You feel what I'm saying? Like, we got Monzo. We got Stacy. You get what I'm saying?
Right.
You get what I'm saying? So they gotta get where Malik getting at right now, you know. So that's how I look at it when I visualize it and whatnot. Like, Malik is actually the first one that's coming from the ones that's coming from the Marzo, the Stacy. You get what I'm saying? Look at Ramos. Ramos is in the mix. You get what I'm saying?
Right,
Yeah,
right.
you know, so when you sit there and look at it, just which,
look, at any given time, the monotony changes, boy.
It can happen. That's just real shit. Look at the mind. The mind is waiting for that opportunity, you know?
Yep, I'd say everybody got their own DNA and their own route to take.
Yeah, you say that all the time, Kenny.
The one at the end will be at the front in a year and a half from now, you know?
That shit can happen. That shit can turn in one day.
Hell yeah. Hell yeah.
But the main thing we got to do is just make sure that we stay on point, stay pushing.
Make sure they stay focused.
Yeah, yeah. That's the main thing, man.
So their dreams come reality. I'm good. I'm 50 years old. It's about them now. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, it's always been about them with me. You know, it's just which one really want to do it. I don't get into that bullshit, man. I ain't got time for it. Get in the gym. Get in the gym. Do what you're supposed to do.
Yeah, we're having fun, man. This is what we want to do. Just push
them
through, you know?
Iceman up first.
Iceman fight October the 10th.
October the 10th. We'll freeze somebody. Put them in a box.
Hey, they're going in the freezer, Cal.
I know. Hey, you put that new lock on the freezer?
Not yet.
Yeah, we got to put that new lock on the freezer. But now you put them in the box, freezer. Iceman, put... Lock their ass in the box.
Damn right.
Yeah, lock their ass in the box. Motherfucker be trying to, let me out, let me out. Nah, motherfucker, we got you now.
Yes, indeed, boy.
Hey, Iceman, we're going to buy a bunch of freezer boxes, and everybody that we knock off, we're going to put them in the box. We're going to put them in the box.
It'd be nice to give away a little freezer at the fight after Iceman clipped
it. Hey, no, that'd be some real shit, yo.
Anybody need a refrigerator for the pan?
Nah. Hey, that's a good look, yo. We could, hey, buy him a whole freezer with some meat in it. That's the meat that he put in the freezer.
For the pandemic.
Yeah.
Survive this pandemic. Can't go freezer sleep.
That's what we should do. Do a raffle. A raffle. And every time he went, they get a whole freezer box with some meat in it. That's the meat they eating. That Ice ate that he put him in a freezer box.
Yo, can you see my bald spot, yo?
Yeah, that big ass bald spot.
Yo, I gotta get my fucking hair lasered out, man. This shit.
Yo, like, you got a little bit of hair growing right there.
Hey, yo, like a damn bird now. That's the shit.
Yo, that shit look crazy.
Man, I'm gonna get my shit lasered out so I can be permanently bald, man.
Yeah, man. Shit. Man, what time it is there?
Right now, it's 9:23.
Shit, y'all about to go in the fucking gym.
Yeah, we ready to grind, and then we going to go back probably about 4:30, 5 o'clock.
Yeah, I start that shit next month.
And I might run them this evening when the sun go down.
I get on that grind next month. We right behind y'all then. Shit.
We got the big run Sunday, though, so.
Yeah, I ain't doing no big runs. All I'm doing is the sprints and shit. I'm going to do the big run when I get, like, down in the, when I get lower. You get what I'm saying? That's that patient shit. I get on top of the patient shit.
We sprint last night. What time was it? About 10 o'clock? About 8:30. 8:30, we was outside sprinting last night.
Yeah. Okay.
We're gonna run tonight, and then Sunday we got the big run.
Right. I run them again. I run them in the morning. Give them a little miles. Give them sand. So when they get up, I don't want to hear no scoops. Let them rest all day. Then go in that gym and let's put that work in.
Man.
Put that work in.
I would say it was, man, can you imagine if they was fighting the same night?
Oh, man, that shit would be lit.
Two different channels, two different places, boy.
Man, it lit, shit,
boy.
Shit be lit.
It's all good, though.
It's that goddamn pandemic. That shit for real.
DMV gonna be lit this month, yo.
Hey, yo, guess what? Tank is one of the second to fight on pay-per-view in the DMV.
But who was it first?
Riddick Bowe. Riddick Bowe and Holyfield.
That was pay-per-view?
Yep. I got the what you call it? Did some research on it.
Riddick Bowe was training in DMV for that fight?
I don't know. Is Riddick Bowe from the DMV or he from New York?
He might have been training here, though.
No, but my question is he from the DMV or is he from New York?
He's from New York because him and Mike Tyson went to school together.
All right, then. So that make Tank the first one from out the DMD fighting on pay-per-view.
Yeah, who the hell said Riddick Bowe?
Because that was the only person that's from the area that I know that's from the area.
No, he's not from this.
I know that. That's why I'm asking you that question.
He was living in D.C.
Right, so he's not actually from the DMV, period.
No.
So that makes that don't. My question was, and when I first answered it, my question was Tank the first person that's fighting pay per view from the DMV? So the only person I know that did it was fighting the on pay per view was Riddick Bowe. And which car? So I'm thinking Riddick Bowe was from the DMV.
Nah.
Yeah, so now you just that's why I call you the Bible. You just notify that he's not from Maryland, Virginia, D.C. You get what I'm saying?
Right.
So then
Ray Leonard, yo. He didn't do no pay-per-view?
I don't think pay-per-view was out. I don't think pay-per-view was out then.
That pay-per-view been out for years, man.
Do the research on it then. Let's answer that question. Can anybody out there in TV land, out there on the what you call it, to find out which fighters that's from the DMV fought pay-per-view? You get what I'm saying?
I think she really fought pay-per-view.
I don't know. I think Floyd and them bought that shit. Floyd and all them bought that shit to the table. Because I think Floyd first pay-per-view fight, or if it was pay-per-view, I forgot his name. Was it the kid from out of Jersey that died?
Gotti.
I think that was Floyd's first pay-per-view.
Oh, okay.
Because I was looking at the pictures on the wall, man, of all the pay-per-view fights.
Mm-hmm.
You get what I'm saying?
So yeah, I think Ray Leonard fought pay-per-view. I ain't sure.
Right. See, that's stuff that we need to look at. You know, we're trying to make history, so you got to go in the history book with that shit.
Right.
So that's the question. Which fighters from the DMV fought pay-per-view? You know what I'm saying? Because I know it ain't been no pay-per-view fighters in almost 20 years from the DMV.
I think Ray and Tank the only one.
Yeah, because I thought my man Sean Bay Mitchell was one of them too.
No, Floyd, but I don't think that was pay-per-view.
Right, that's what I'm saying. That's the thing. That's the question, you know?
Yeah. I'm gonna research and find out though.
Yeah. But that's a good thing. Riddick Bowe and them posted did 6,000 views for that fight.
600,000
or whatever. I know it was in the six.
No, I said
600,000 with a six. I know it's in the six. That was the numbers for them.
That ain't bad.
No, it ain't bad, but I'm saying, you know, let's see what the fuck we gonna do.
Yeah.
Push that envelope, baby. That's how I look at it.
Hey, if this number's jumping this pandemic with ain't no view, that's gonna be something because everybody's home, but everybody ain't working. You know what
right,
I'm saying?
Right. Shit. Oh, it's like a billion phones, man. Motherfuckers gonna put that shit on that phone. We're gonna lit that phone up.
Yeah, they looking for something to do, not something to see. You know?
Yeah, I feel you on that. So the question is again, who's our pay-per-view fighters out of the DMV? That's what I need to find out.
You know who you can call to find out for sure?
Who like that on that type of subject?
Juice.
Ah, yeah, Juice a bad boy with that shit. Or you can call an old man on boxing on the Beltway.